is going to be stitched to the white.
First one's the hardest.
Goes through the eye of the needle.
It's see-through.
Oh, cool.
It
wow. Busy, busy fingers inside of the Maryland Historical Society stitching a piece of history. Nearly 1,000 people are recreating the Star-Spangled Banner flag that flew over Fort McHenry during the Battle of Baltimore in 1814 and inspired Francis Scott Key to write what became our national anthem.
I believe this is my fifth day, and I try to put in 4 or 5 hours.
They started on the 4th of July. Kay Campbell Anderson is one of the official stitchers recruited from local sewing clubs and quilting guilds.
You're going through all 4 layers of the bunting.
They help out hundreds of amateurs, members of the public, welcomed in to take a stitch and be part of history.
Yes, I'm very nervous. As you can see, I'm not the best threader.
We usually take one stitch and let them pull the thread. And the second time, we let them take a stitch all the way through the fabric.
They're using wool bunting, like the fabric used in the original flag, and the same sewing techniques used more than 200 years ago.
Because of the weave of the fabric, you have to kind of go zigzag up and down, so that's a little bit different.
Everyone who completes a stitch gets a memento, an official recognition. Our crew from WBAL tried it out.
It's just really, really exciting to know that you're making that star stick to that fabric and it's going to fly here.
Once it's done, the flag will be moved to the War of 1812 and Defenders Day celebrations at Fort McHenry.
We had people on Saturday who they were looking at, they knew that they were sewing the bottom stripe and that their stitch was 8 feet from the edge. And when they're going to watch it fly on Defenders Day, they're going to go, that's where my stitch is right there.
The 6-week project ends on August 22nd. Organizers expect to see 8,000 to 10,000 people at Fort McHenry on Defenders Day. Reporting at the Maryland Historical Society, Kyrie, WBAL-TV 11 News.